Watauga Arts Council with your host, Cherry Johnson, serving arts in Watauga County for more than 30 years.
Hello, I'm Cherry Johnson with Watauga County Arts Council, and one of the things that we do in this community is trying to further the arts, no matter who's doing them. And one thing you've seen a lot of this spring is where I have been showcasing some of the talented performers that we have at our university, and I've got a whole house full of them. And what's even better is they've got the right message. That you are Spring Awakening, is that not the name of your production?
It is, sure.
Okay,
is.
You could not have timed this any better. We were just talking before we started taping about how, you know, you get tired of winter and it's just dragging on you. So it's high time for spring to awaken. So
amen.
We're ready. I have to have a cheat sheet because I keep mixing these guys up. I have Luke Schaefer.
Yes.
You are not Will. You are Luke. And Kelly Lettner.
Yes.
And I have with me Dominique, how's your last name? Atwater.
Atwater, yes.
Oh, that's not so hard. And Will Allen.
Yep.
And you may remember, you've seen Will and Luke with me before, varied times over the years as they've grown in their careers. I don't think either of you girls have ever been with me before.
I think once or twice.
You have?
Maybe, yeah.
Okay. Okay. Well, I know Dominique. And you guys are all theater students?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And
music.
You're also
Dominique.
What are you?
Student.
You're music.
Music student. Music
not that I'm surprised. We've gone ahead and taped a little segment of this production for you, and somebody tell them what they're going to hear, and then we'll let Max play that. So what was the production? I mean, what was the song?
We sang a clip from Mama Who Bore Me the Reprise. It's sung by five women in the show. So we were not actually the ones that are going to be singing it.
I was going to say, Will and Luke did not look like women.
No, they didn't. There's going to be five of the characters in the show are going to be singing that piece. So
okay, great. Well, we're going to let Max play that for you because it's going to give us a way to jump off into this production.
Mama who bore me, Mama who gave me, Mama the angels. Who made me so sad? Mama who bore me, Mama who gave me no way to handle things, who made me so sad? Mama the weeping, Mama the angels, no sleep in heaven or Bethlehem, no sleep in heaven or Bethlehem.
Talented.
Thank you.
Great. You are a music student. Big surprise.
Thank you.
That's a voice. You've got a great voice.
Thank you.
And I got kind of tickled at you. You had your hands in your pockets, mm-hmm. And then you got to do that. That's because this isn't your song. You're just faking it, right?
Yep.
Playing the part of a woman.
Yep.
Just a little.
You guys are good actors.
They are. Wonderful.
Yes.
Now, would you agree? You're the director of this production, right?
Yes.
Did you select your cast, or were they selected for you?
Yes, I did. I selected my cast, mm-hmm. which was wonderful. We had a two-part audition process,
mm-hmm.
and Dominique and I, we selected our cast, handpicked
you're
them.
So. Part of the selection process, you
I'm the music director.
Yes.
Gotcha.
Yes, ma'am. I lead all the music rehearsals,
mm-hmm.
teach them the notes, and then their beautiful voices speak for themselves.
That's great. And mm-hmm. Kelly, obviously, you said something to me earlier about dance. You have something to do with dance?
Yes, I'm the director and the choreographer for the
mm-hmm.
show.
Okay. So are you a dance major as well?
I'm not. I'm a dance minor.
Dance minor.
Yes.
Okay. So let's talk a little bit about the production itself. What's the theme of this production?
You know, the theme of this production is really a coming-of-age story,
mm-hmm.
is what's at the heart of the production.
Right.
And these things that every single person faces as they're coming into themselves and getting to know who they are in the world.
Yeah.
So that's really the main underlying theme, so things that, like, everyone can relate to.
So how does that tie into Spring Awakening?
Well, it's kind of like a metaphorical Spring Awakening, you know, spring being this dawning of a new age in your life and coming into yourself and understanding who you are.
Okay.
So it relates really nicely with us, you know, coming out of this long winter that we've had.
Great. Well, I'm really excited about that part of
Me too.
Okay, what roles do the... Now, you're the music director.
Yes, ma'am.
So that means that you are... Did you were you looking for good voices? Was that the whole point?
Absolutely. During the selection process, mm-hmm. we took a lot of notes, and she was looking for the acting side of things.
Right.
And I did a lot of vocalization and listening to people and how they match their pitches and things mm-hmm. like that. Can they sing in harmony?
And do can the they voices carry actually go together?
Come together, exactly. Mm-hmm. So that's my role in the selection process.
Y'all come to heads over this?
We did not.
No. We were
it was actually
much
a really smooth
really
process. Smooth. So that was
because I can envision someone who sings beautifully, but they just don't fit Kelly's idea.
Exactly right. And we, everyone is spot on. We're mm-hmm. so excited about the cast we chose. So yeah, it was seamless.
Now, how do these great. Guys fit into the production?
I play Melchior Gabor. So I'm one of the kids who is learning more about himself, mm-hmm. kind of coming of age. So.
So you finally get there.
Yes, I do.
Just like every teenager finally gets there.
Yeah. Yes. Whether they like it or not.
Exactly.
What about you?
And I play a boy named Hanshin Rilo, who again is coming of age, uh-huh. and he makes it.
That's great. Now, how many people are in the whole cast?
We have a cast of...
11.
11. Mm-hmm. We have a cast of 11.
11 children.
11 children and two adults.
Two adults, so 13 altogether.
Well, as in 11 children acting, acting the role of children.
Yes, it's all
not child
college
actors.
Age. Yeah. No. College age actors. Uh-huh. And we have two also college age actors that are playing the roles of adults in the show. So.
All right. And then are you on stage at all?
I am not.
You're not?
No.
But you are.
I'm not.
You're not?
No.
Okay.
I'll sit in the pit and direct the band. There's a whole band, piano, guitar, bass, cello, violin, viola. Drums.
Pit. Where do we have a pit?
I guess it'll be on a raised platform, so
gotcha.
the band will be in the back, and the actors will be in front of the band.
Mm-hmm.
So I'll have a little wand or a stick or something and try to get them to stay on cue. But y'all won't see me.
You've not practiced with a wand or a stick?
Not quite yet. I've been using a pencil recently.
It works in this bright yellow. You can
there
see
you go. There you go. But no, you won't see my face on stage this time.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So that backstage, what is backstage? How many people are backstage?
Right now, we have a really small crew. It'll be Dominique conducting. Mm-hmm. I'll be in the back running around. Our stage manager, Madeline Hintz, mm-hmm. our assistant stage manager, Catherine Alexander, will be back there. And then our lighting and sound engineer, Matt Hudak. And then I think we have like two more people crewing for us. So
now, did you also have people doing costuming and that kind of thing back
yes,
in the background?
Yes, actually, Will is the costume designer for the show.
Really?
As well.
Yeah, this is the second time for the Appalachian Musical Theater Club that we've gotten to do a show where I've gotten the chance to costume design.
I didn't know you did that.
Yes.
I've seen him several times. You've never let that part of it out.
Yeah, I work in the shop on campus.
Uh-huh.
So it's just kind of like come along that we're learning as we're getting older, mm-hmm. just like these kids in the show are, that like anything makes you a little bit more marketable. So
that's great.
I've kind of like gotten to cultivate that skill and gotten the chance to work on this show, and it's been great. It's been fun too, because we got a budget from the club, mm-hmm. and so it's been a lot about like thrifting things and then turning them around into what we want them to be.
Right.
So a lot of Goodwill shopping, a lot uh-huh. of like being at Ram's Rack on King Street. Right. And
the Arts Council had a yacht sale last spring,
yes.
and Ensemble Stage was one of our first customers.
Yes.
So, and I realized that in the theater world, you know, used is good,
mm-hmm.
you know,
oh, yeah.
and it often
yeah.
makes it even more
yeah.
authentic,
yeah.
definitely.
Yes,
uh-huh.
exactly.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly. So now, this production takes place in what time period?
It's in the late 1800s in Germany.
Oh,
but
my goodness.
It's more of like a modern take. It was a play first
mm-hmm.
that was adapted into a musical only in the early 2000s. So it's more of a modern take on that time period, but
so
still.
So were you doing costumes from that period?
Yes.
Uh-huh.
All of the boys are in a boarding school,
mm-hmm.
So they are pretty similar in look, and we're kind of going with like a grayscale kind of thing, so
yeah.
It's cool. It's been a lot of fun to try to figure out how to take something from Goodwill that's everything is so 90s at Goodwill.
I was going to say.
and turn it into what we need it to be, mm-hmm. but it's been fun. So.
So you're not sewing in the middle of the night?
Sometimes, but it's fun. It's all stuff that we love to do, so none of us really mind staying up too late.
Now, did you have a set designed for this production, or is it?
We have a little bit of a set that was kind of an idea that we came up with.
Mm-hmm.
we just, it's, well, I'll let it be a surprise for the production, but it's just something really simple. We wanted the show to really speak for itself. And so it's got a very powerful message. And so we wanted to do something really simplistic that could just add to the show rather than distract from it. So it's going to be really nice and really an intimate performance.
You'll have to come to see.
Well, and we need to tell them where it is. Where is this performance happening?
It's in the Plemons Student Union in the Blue Ridge Ballroom.
And it's going to be on?
It's on March 29th and 30th at 7:30 p.m. And it's ages 18 and older only with ID required.
Because there's things that are appropriate for children.
Right. Well, there's partial nudity and mature subject matter.
Gotcha. Okay. So what is this going to do for your career, having done this?
You know, I'm not even really looking at it as, like, what is it going to do for my career? I'm just looking at it as a really great experience with a phenomenal cast.
That's great.
And I'm just looking forward to next week and what we're going to do as a show and who we get to share it with in the community.
Same with you.
Getting to come together with all my friends, too, is almost the best part.
Right.
They they look great. They sound great. But the fact that I get to hang out with them every day is
awesome.
The best part.
And we've worked with some of the people in our cast since freshman year.
Yeah.
The three of us were in our first show at App together. So it's
Four
kind of like
ago.
we're finishing out everything together.
And
so
it doesn't hurt to work on a Tony Award winning musical.
Yeah. Yeah.
So this is going to be resume building for all of you, I hate to tell you.
Yes.
It is.
It's a great experience, and it'll help us.
Right.
So,
all right, now what year are we in process?
A senior.
You're a senior? Oh, you're getting ready to leave us.
I know.
Okay.
I'm a senior
Kelly,
as well.
Kelly, you too. Wow.
We're both seniors,
Oh, my goodness.
This is the last time I'll get to see you guys. I feel like I know these fellows because we've done several interviews over time with various pieces. You're the only newcomer.
I know, I just met you.
Yeah, well, we have to make up for lost time.
That's right. So we'll get coffee.
Okay. We'll invite you. So I really do, I hear you all talking about varied productions, about working together, about the relationships within the group, and I hear very strongly that you're a family. And that you have relationships with the group that will last for many, many years to come and maybe the rest of your lives. And so I'm very, very impressed with what you guys can put on and produce and build relationships at the same time and not kill each other and, you know.
Yeah. Not yet. Not yet.
Graduation's only a little ways down the road.
We can make it till May.
Exactly. Well, let's go over the details one last time. It's March 29th and 30th.
Yes.
At the Plemons Student Union.
Yes, at 7:30 p.m.
Okay, and tickets are how much?
They are $8 for students and faculty in advance, or Appalachian staff, and they are $10 flat at the door.
No matter who you are.
No matter who you are.
Okay. And then at the Plemons Student Union, that's a big place. Where?
It is. If you go to the information desk, that's right across from Cascades, that's where they sell all the tickets. If you go up to the information desk with your ID, you can buy the tickets there.
Okay, that's great.
And parking, I know that's a really big deal
sure
on
is.
Campus. It's really confusing. You can park at the River Street parking deck. That is going to be the best. It's going to be free at that time. Or anywhere on campus after 5 you can park.
Okay.
But River Street would probably be the closest.
Okay. Right. You think that's close?
That or
maybe
library
the library
deck. But either or, they're gonna have the biggest
parking.
Amount of spots available.
Right, and the library parking deck will be open as well.
It sure will.
Okay. All right, well then we solved all your problems. Once we solve parking, it's all solved. So please enjoy this production with these students. I think it's a wonderful way to not just kick off spring, but kind of cap a great career with you guys too. You know, do you have any more productions in your lifetime at Appalachian?
We have one more coming up April 11th through 13th at the Schaefer Center for the Performing Arts, and it's Kiss Me, Kate.
Oh, you're going to end with a big finale.
Yes, we are.
We also have a few student shows coming up. We have David Auburn's Proof is coming up April 17th and 18th. And the other ones are when?
We have faculty Derek Davidson.
Oh, I know Derek.
He wrote a play called A Part Equal that is going on this upcoming, or next, the weekend after next. So the weekend after Spring Awakening.
Right.
That's April.
It's the first weekend of April.
4th and 5th?
Something like that.
We've got something every single weekend pretty much until Kiss Me, Kate is, I think.
And all these things. Even after.
All these things are on the website.
Yes, everything should be on the Appalachian State website, appstate.edu. All of the dates should be on the right-hand side of your screen when you look out on your computer.
Okay, so go there instead of the theater website?
Yes, that would probably be the easiest because it tracks most of the events right on the homepage.
Oh, okay. Well, that's great. Well, it's good to know you make the front page.
Yeah.
Well, thank you all for coming and joining me, and I hope that we've enticed a few folks to attend this performance and that they're going to be standing at the door with their $10 bills waiting to get in. and as they say in the business, I hear, break a leg, you know.
So. Yeah. Thank you.
So much.
Thank
you.
Check our website, watauga-arts.org, for information about this and a lot more.
Watauga Arts Council with your host, Cherry Johnson, serving arts in Watauga County for more than 30 years.